Good day to everyone. So our topic is all about the institutional correction. So sa Pilipinas kasi we have two approaches of correction. We have the institutional and the non-institutional correction. So when we say institutional, it pertains to the jails and the correctional facilities, while the non-institutional is ito yung tinatawag nating community-based correction, wherein the convicted offender served their sentence outside the prison facilities. So we all know that correction is the fourth agency which serves as the serve another vital role in the criminal justice system. Okay. So it is in the correctional institution where sentenced person are trained and rehabilitated to start a new life. Okay. So the correctional agencies under the executive organ of the government with the Bureau of Correction as the main agency, and it is headed by a director. Okay. So when we say correction, it is the fourth pillar of the criminal justice system. That takes over once the accused, after having been found guilty, okay, and meted out the penalty for the crime he committed. So, for those first-time offender, they may apply for probation, okay, or he could be turned over to an institutional or institutional agency, okay, or facility for custodial treatment and rehabilitation. So the offender could avail the what we call the benefits. Okay, he can avail for the benefits of parole or other executive clemency once he has served the minimum period of his sentence. Okay. So when the penalty is imprisonment, the sentence is carried out either in the municipal, provincial, or national penitentiary, depending on the length of the sentence meted. Okay. Depende kasi sa sentence yan kung qualified siya sa municipal, city jail, provincial, or national penitentiary. So, correction is a branch of criminal justice system concerned with the custody, supervision, and rehabilitation of convicted offender. Okay. So, as a process, it refers to the reorientation or instruction of the criminal offender in order to prevent him or her from repeating his deviant or delinquent action. So, in the correction, in correcting the deviant behavior of the offender, okay, the process that does not consider the necessity of taking punitive action. Okay. So ito yung ibig sabihin ng correction. Okay. So next is penology. Ano naman ang ibig sabihin ng penology? Okay. So penology is the study of punishment for crime or of criminal offenders. So it can includes the study of control and prevention of crime through punishment of criminal offenders. So this is penology. So penology is the word penology is derived from the Latin word pena, nang ibig sabihin ay pain or suffering. And this is also the old term na ginagamit yung penology, but today the accepted term use is correction. So penology is also called the penal science. So when we say penal science, the division of criminology that concerns itself with the philosophy and practice of society in its effort to repress criminal activities. Okay. So yan yung ibig sabihin ng penology. How about penal management? When we say penal management is the manner or practice of managing or controlling places of confinement as jails or prison. How do you manage the prison facility or a jail facility? That is penal management. Kasi kapag ang pinag-uusapan natin dito ay correction na, okay, dapat nating malaman din ano ba ang ibig sabihin o pagkakaiba ng punishment and penalty. Okay? So, when we say penalty, okay, or punishment, when we say punishment is it is the penalty imposed for the transgression of law, or it refers to any ill suffered in consequence of wrong doing. Okay, so one of the example of punishment is spanking of children or pamamaro sa bata, open arms. That is an example of punishment. Okay. So while penalty is referring to the consequences. Okay. What are these consequences such as suffering or loss, okay, that follow the transgression of laws. Okay. Pag sinabi kasi nating penalty is a legal sentence. So that is the difference between the punishment and the penalty. Okay, let's continue. So what are the justification of punishment? Okay. So pag sinabi kasi natin justification, okay, para lang ma-justify natin bakit may punishment. Okay, first is yung tinatawag nating retribution. So ano bang ibig sabihin ng retribution? Ito yung pagganti. Okay? Because during the primitive day, okay, punishment of the transgressor was carried out in the form of personal vengeance. Okay. Another one is expiation. Okay. So yung pagbabayad sala, okay, atonement. Okay. If an offense was committed by a member against another member of the same clan or group, okay, arouse the condemnation of the whole group against the offending party. Okay. So the group would therefore demand that the offender must be punished. Okay. So expiation therefore is a group vengeance as distinguished to the retribution, which is personal vengeance. Okay, ito ay grupo expiation, while the retribution is a personal vengeance. Okay, the other one is deterrence. Okay. So when we say deterrence, it is commonly believed that punishment gives a lesson, okay, to the offender. Okay. Binibigyan tayo ng lesson kapag tayo ay nakaranas na ng punishment. Okay. So that is it shows the other than what would happen if they violate the law. Siyempre kung nakaranas na tayo ng punishment, is medyo matatakot na tayong gumawa ng krimen or paglabag sa mga alituntunin or okay. The other one is protection. So one of the justification of punishment is protection. When you say protection, protection as a justification of punishment came after prison were fully established. Okay. Ang mga tao naniniwala kasi na by putting the offender in prison, this society is protected from his further criminal depredation. Okay. The vicious and dangerous criminals are made to serve a long term of imprisonment. Okay. To protect the public from harm or against there are dangerous behavior. That is protection as a justification of punishment. And the other one is reformation. So under this theory, under the theory of reformation, this society can best be protected. Okay, mas napoprotektahan ang society. Okay. From any crime, okay, if the purpose of imprisonment is to reform or rehabilitate the prisoner, okay, mas magandang i-reform mo yung prisoner or i-rehabilitate mo yung prisoner, okay, para masigurado natin na talagang protected tayo sa mga deviant behavior na yan or sa mga criminal na yan. Okay, let's continue the discussion. So we'll go now to the what we call the imprisonment. Okay, so when we say imprisonment, it is it refers to the state or condition of being constrained, ano, pinipigilan mo yan, restrained or incarcerated in confined room or building, kinukulong. That is what we call the imprisonment. But imprisonment is actually a form of conventional punishment, okay, of criminal offender. So there are traditional purposes of imprisonment. Okay, first is to ensure the presence of the accused during trial para masigurado natin na dadalo sa kanyang pagdinig ang kanyang kaso. Okay, to administer punishment by confinement or incarceration. This is after the conviction, ikukulong na yan. And to secure the security of the society from being molested by undesirable character. So these are the traditional purposes of imprisonment. Okay, so we'll go now to the purposes of correction. So what are the purposes of correction? Okay, first is punishment. So when we say punishment, for every deviant acts, okay, committed by any person, there is a corresponding penalty. Okay, merong corresponding penalty if you commit any deviant acts. Okay, but it that is prohibited by law. Okay, so. Ever since in the history of crime, there are forms of punishment different forms of punishment that has been introduced. So those punishment are, we can say, barbaric or inhuman. Okay. Inhuman punishment. So ano-ano yung mga barbaric punishment? Okay, strangulation, hanging to death, okay, feeding to animals. Okay, those are example of barbaric punishment. But the introduction of the correctional philosophy, okay, in the penal institution prompted the modification of this trend. As a result of this innovation, the form or manner of imposing punishment today is somewhat or geared in a more humanitarian way. So next is deterrent. So punishment is imposed against the offender. Okay. Has the effect of deterring others. So kapag nakita ng iba kasi na mayroong nakulong, it will deter other people to commit deviant act. Okay? So to pursue or preconceive evil act or not is measured in terms of pleasure, okay, and pain to be gained and suffered by would be offender. So matatakot na yung ibang tao kapag nakita nilang may nakulong. That is deterrent. Okay. So other one is isolation. So the rest of the members of the society do not want to be contaminated. Ayaw naman nating mahaluan tayo ng mga criminal behavior, pagka-criminal, magkakaroon, ayaw nating mahaluan yung society natin ng mga hindi magandang pag-ugali. Okay? Lalo-lalo na sa mga criminal, okay? Sa mga offender. Okay? So, one of the effective way is to isolate those criminal from the society. That is isolation. Ilayo natin sila sa society. Okay? So the construction of jail and prison as a confinement place for the criminal would isolate isolate bad apples from the good apples in a barrel. Iwalay natin yung mga bulok sa mga magaganda. Okay, that is isolation. Another one is rehabilitation. So rehabilitation is introduced. Okay, under the new concept of penology. So the purpose the purpose accepts, okay, the fact that criminal are not inherently bad. Hindi naman talagang masama yung mga criminal na yan. So we need to reform or rehabilitate those convicted offender. Okay, they become only a criminal because of some condition beyond their control. So that is rehabilitation, and the other one is reintegration. So reintegration is the latest philosophical basis for correction, the reintegration in the society. So once the convict, okay, succeeds in the rehabilitation phase, he is reintroduced or reintegrated in the society. So the society, ang gagawin naman ng society is we need to accept those convicted offender with unopen arms. Kasi kapag hindi natin sila tinanggap, eh, babalik at babalik talaga sa pagiging criminal ng mga yan. Okay? So we will go now to the early codes in relation to correction. So ano-ano yung mga iba't-ibang o yung mga sinaunang batas na may relasyon sa tinatawag nating correction. So one of the early codes is the code of Ur-Nammu. So the oldest code known to man. Okay, the code of Ur-Nammu institute fines of monetary compensation for bodily damage as opposed to the lex talionis. So ano ba yung lex talionis? The eye for an eye, foot tooth for a tooth. Okay. So yun yung tinatawag nating code of Ur-Nammu. And the concept of this code is the justice or is that in retribution, justice flows from the victim to the offender, while in restitution, justice flows from the offender to the victim. That is the concept of code of Ur-Nammu. So this code was carries the concept of restorative justice. Okay, another one is the code of Isyuna. When you say Isyuna, a Sumerian code which or a Sumerian law which chronicles the rights of citizens, marriages, succession, property rights, and penalties. Okay, Sumerian code forbid the accepting of money or objects from the hand of slaves. So another one is the code of Hammurabi. The code of Hammurabi, its core principle is the concept of justice known as the lex talionis, or eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. Okay. So next is the code of Lipitistat. Okay. So or the code of Draco. When we say code of Draco, it provides the same punishment both citizens and the slaves. Okay. This was the first written law in Greece, the code of Draco. So in Greece, around 629 BC, the code of Draco was enforced. So a harsh code that provides the same punishment, okay, for both citizens and the slave. And the next one is the Solon's law. So the Solon's law, this law repealed the Draco's law and allowed capital punishment for a limited number of serious offenses. So it gave the right of representation of every person to claim redress on behalf of another to whom wrong was being done. So the penalty in the sa Solon's law, okay, so it also gives the representation of every person to claim redress on behalf of another, okay, to whom wrong was being done. So in the code of Draco, the capital punishment is death. Another one is the Mosaic Code. Okay, the Mosaic Code or the Law of Moses, okay, is a biblical term that first found in the book of Joshua, where he writes the Law of Moses on the altar of Mount Ebal. Okay. So the Mosaic Code is premised on the concept of retribution. The other one is the 12 Tables Law. This is the foundation of the Roman law. Okay, it was the ancient legislation that stood, okay, as the foundation of the Roman law. So the 12 table came out about as a result of the long social struggle between the patrician and the plebeians. Okay, another one is the Justinian Code. Okay, this code became the standard law of the in all areas okay occupied by Roman Empire. And this is also the revision of the 12 tables of Roman law. Okay, that is originated about 500 BC. And the first Justinian Code was completed in 529 BC. Okay, next is the Burgundian Code. So in this this code introduced the concept of retribution. Restitution, I should say. But punishment were meted according to the social class of the offender. Ano ba ibig sabihin ng according to the social class of the offender? Kasi yung mga slave noon, sila yung mga lagi na paparusahan ng capital punishment. Unlike the noble or yung mga mayayaman, is medyo mas magaan yung kanilang mga parusa. That is the Burgundian Code. So, secular code. Okay, this code were advocated by Christian philosophers who recognize the need for justice. Okay, some of the proponent of this laws of this law were Saint Augustine and Saint Thomas Aquinas. During this period, there are three laws. Okay, three laws were distinguished. Okay, the external law, the natural law, and the human law. All these laws are intended for the common good, but human law becomes only valid if it does not conflict with the other two laws. Another one is the Judean Christian theory. So in this Judean Christian theory is the canonical courts, okay, refused to recognize state courts and allow jurisdiction over crimes of heresy, blasphemy, and witchcraft. Yung blasphemy. Okay, yung kalapastanganan or yung ang pinaparusahan nito is yung mga mangkukulam, witchcraft. So these are the early legal codes in relation to correction. Okay. So we'll go now to the forms of punishment, ancient to contemporary. Okay, first is the capital punishment. The capital punishment is death. Okay, there are many forms of capital punishment. We have the burning at stake. We have the beheading, broken on wheels, garroting. These are forms of capital punishment. Okay. So burning at stake, pagsusunog ng buhay. Okay, corporal punishment. Okay, the corporal punishment, these are physical torture. Okay. So dito sa burning at stake, the first recorded Christian who was put to death for being heretic is Priscillian. Okay, he is the first Christian. Okay. So public humiliation, stocks, pillory, banishment or exile, mutilation, blood feud, vengeance, flogging, tatunayan tales, furka, Russian now, polo servicio, penal servitude, julius, vestal virgin, outlaw or exile, and ordeal. So these are the forms of punishment from ancient to contemporary. So the meaning of this punishment is already in your module. So these are the timeline, okay, from dark ages to the golden age of phenology. Okay, so in the Middle Ages kasi the social structure of the growing influence of the church on everyday lives, so malaki kasi resulted in a divided system of justice. Okay, so Reformation was viewed as a process of religious, not secular or redemption. Okay, the sinner had to pay two debts, okay, one to the society and one to another, and the another is to God. Okay, from 5th to 11th century, this is the age, or the what we call dark ages or early middle ages. Okay, then the 13th century is securing a sanctuary, okay, place of asylum, of refuge open to unpremeditated crimes where criminals can seek refuge for 90 days. Okay, so from the 16th century, so the transportation became a prevalent form of punishment. Then 16th to 17th century, conceptualization of workhouses in England, where inmates work at an organized production for the profit of commercial firm. And the 18th century, ito na yung tinatawag nating age of enlightenment, or the advent of the classical school of criminology. Okay, so dito ang tawag sa gaol, gaols ay jails, ang jails ay gaols, and the jailers is gaoler. Okay, and 1870 to 1880, this was the golden age of phenology. Okay, in the golden age of phenology, okay, dito na nabuo yung national prison association in Ohio, and the first implementation of or first international prison congress. Okay, it was held in London in 1872, and which established the International Penal and Penitentiary Commission sa Hague. And the Elmira Reformatory was established in New York in 1876. And also the first separate institution for women were established in Indiana, Massachusetts. Okay. So we'll go now to the pioneers in correctional reform. Okay. First is William Penn. So si William Penn is he fought for religious freedom and individual rights, and he was the first to prescribe imprisonment as correctional treatment for major offenders. Okay, he also fought for the abolition of death penalty. While Benjamin Rush, okay, so he is a physician, patriot, signer of the Declaration of Independence, and social reformer, advocated the Penitentiary Act as a replacement for capital and corporal punishment. Charles Montesquieu, a French historian, okay, and a philosopher who analyzed law as an expression of justice. He is famous for his advocacy and reforming slavery as a means of punishment. And also, he is famous for the theory of separation of powers of the legislative, judiciary, and the executive. Okay, Charles Montesquieu is also known as Charles Louis Secondat Baron de la Brede et de Montesquieu. Okay, next is John Locke. who is Janlak. So Janlak is the founder of the school of empiricism. Okay. And he also said that man is born good, independent and equal. So next is Francois Marie Arouet, or pen name, his pen name is Voltaire. So he was the most versatile of all philosophers during this period. Okay, he believed that fear of shame was deterrent to crime, and he also fought the legality sanctioned the practice of torture. And next is Cesar Beccaria. See, Cesar Beccaria, he wrote an essay. Okay, what is this essay? An essay on crimes and punishment, the most exciting essay on law during his time. Okay, as it presented the humanistic goals of law. Jeremy Bentham is the greatest leader in the reform of English criminal law. Okay. He believed that whatever punishment designed to negate whatever pleasure or gain the criminal derives from the crime, the same. Okay. Derives from crime, the crime rate would go down. And he was also famous on the for the Panopticon. Okay. Panopticon prison. Panopticon means all-seeing eye. The next is John Howard. Okay. The John Howard is the father of prison reform. He is a sheriff of Bedfordshire who devoted his life and fortune to prison reform. So the recommendation of John Howard, okay, after his findings on English prison, okay, he recommended the following: maintenance of facilities for children, segregation of women from other offenders, segregation of youth, provision of sanitation facilities, and adequate salaries for jailers. Okay. So next is Sir Samuel Romilly. Okay, si Romilly is the follower of Jeremy Bentham, and was unable a lawyer, okay, and the most effective leader in direct and persistent agitation of for reform of the English criminal code. He pressed the construction of the first modern English prison, the Millbank, in 1860. So, I'll go back to John Howard. So, many of the landmark of recommendation was incorporated in the Penitentiary Act of 1779 and adopted as a standard procedure in the first modern prison constructed in 1785 in Norfolk, England. Okay. So next is Robert Peel. Si Sir Robert Peel was a leader. Okay. The leader of English legislature for reform of the criminal code. Okay. He established the Irish constabulary called the Peelers. And in 1829, he started the London Metropolitan Police known as Babis. Next is Manuel Montesinos, who was the director of the prisons of Valencia, Spain in 1835, and divided prisoners into companies and appointed prisoners as petty officers in charge. Okay. And next is Alexander Macanocci, known as the father of parole, and he served as superintendent of a penal colony in Norfolk Island in Australia, and he developed the what we call the mark system. So parole started in US in 1876 at the Elmira Reformatory, and the first probation law was passed in Massachusetts in 78. Next is Edward and Savage. So what is the contribution of Edward Savage? Okay. Si Edward Savage is the former chief of police in Boston and appointed as the first government probation officer in 1887. So next is Sir Walter Crockton. Okay. He became the chairman of the directors of Irish Prison. Okay. The chairman of the directors of Irish Prisons, and in 1856, he introduced the Irish system or the indeterminate system, and later on called the progressive stage system. Okay. So next is Frederick Auguste de Metz. So si de Metz is the famous for the establishment of agricultural colony, okay, for delinquent boys in France in 1839. Next is Zebulon Brockway. So si Zebulon Brockway served as the superintendent when New York State Reformatory at Elmira was opened in 1876. Okay. He will introduce in Elmira a new institutional program for the boys from 16 to 30 years of age. And he is regarded as the father of American parole in the U.S. Okay. Next is Sir Evelyn Ragus Breeze. Si Breeze became a director of the Borstal Institution. He opened the Borstal Institution of England and became the earliest best reform institution for young offender. So yung Borstal Institution kasi is the best institution for the reformation and rehabilitation of juvenile offenders. Okay, it was located in United Kingdom, England. Okay. And it houses criminals age 21 years old below. So next is the Child Savers. So Child Savers is a group of reformers focusing on young offenders. They developed the what we call the cottage system in existing penal institution, where youth offenders were divided into small groups for housing and other activities like congregate workers and the adult prison sweatshop. Okay, next is Elam Lins. So Elam Lins became a warden of Auburn and later of Sing Sing Prison. Siya yung nagtayo ng Sing Sing Prison. Okay. So later on, I will discuss to you what is Sing Sing Prison. Ano ba yung nandun sa Sing Sing Prison? Okay, next is Sir William Blackstone, the author of the Penitentiary Act of 1779. Okay. Based on the work of John Howard, okay, one of the lead authors of the neoclassical theory. Next is John Haviland, an English-born architect and one of the most notable architects working from Philadelphia in the 19th century. Okay. And James Bennett, the became the director of the Federal Bureau of Prison. And the James Bennett is a writer. Okay. He wrote about the closing of the Alcatraz prison. And he also built the Federal Correctional Institution in Sergoville, Texas. Okay. Next is Ellen Cheney Johnson. He founded the New England Women's Auxiliary Association to the United States Sanitary Commission and served as superintendent to the Massachusetts Reformatory Prison for Women. Okay, at Framingham. And also, she pushed for the establishment of an all-women prison in 1877. Next is Sanford Bates. See, Sanford Bates is a legendary figure, okay, in American correction. Okay. He was a president of the American Correctional Association in 1926, and he became the first superintendent of the federal prison in 1929, and first director of the United States Bureau of Prisons in 1930. So aside from that, he became the executive director of the Boys Clubs of America in 1937, and he is the one who introduced the procedures into the U.S. Bureau of Prison in 1930. So one of the contribution, there are two major contributions of Sanford Bates. Okay. One is the diagnosis and the classification of the use of professional personnel. Okay. Kagaya ng psychiatrist. Okay, and the psychologist to help to rehabilitate convicted offender. Next is J. Edgar Hoover. He became the director of the Federal Bureau of Investigation, or FBI, and his war on crime helped give the world super maximum prison known as the Alcatraz. Okay. Dito nagsimulang naipatay. Dito naipatay yung tinatawag nating Alcatraz. Okay, but in 1963, Alcatraz was closed. Okay. And next is Olin Guy Blackwell. Okay, he was the fourth and final warden of Alcatraz Federal Penitentiary. Okay. But in 1962, it was the time of the infamous June escape from Alcatraz, yung mayroong nakatakas doon sa super maximum na Alcatraz. Okay. So next is Fred Wilkinson, became the director of the Department of Correction. So these are the pioneers in correctional reform. Okay. So what are the early prisons and correctional institution? So first is the Mamertin Prison, or the Carcere Mamertino. This is the oldest prison, can be traced to the ancient Rome. It is a series of dungeons, and it was originally designed as a reservoir of water. The Lestin's prison, it was built in 1290s in Florence, Italy. It housed male inmates separately from female inmates, and also segregated inmates by age group, degree of sanity, and severity of offense. The Bridewell Institution, it was established in 1556 in Bridewell, England, as a workhouse for vagabonds, idlers, and roughs. So in Bridewell Institution, vagrants and prostitutes were given work while serving their sentences. Okay. Ito yung tinatawag nating Bridewell system. Main State Prison, it is a prison contained with contained cells in a pit similar to the underground cistern of the Rome that are used to detain offenders. Okay, undergoing trial in some cases and to hold offenders where they will be starved to death. Ginugutom magmayan hanggang sa mamatay. Yan yung main state prison doon. So these pits are entered through an iron gate in the ceiling and are being used as late as 1828. So ito na yung Sing Sing prison. Became famous because of the Sing Sing bat. Okay? Ito yung tinatawag natin shower bat. It is a gadget constructed to drop a volume of water on the head of the of a naked offender. Okay, binubuhusan ng malamig. Okay? Malamig, maraming tubig yung ulo ng isang tao. This is a kind of barbaric punishment. Okay? Hospicio de San Michel or hospice of of Saint Michael. It was established in 1704 at the Hospital of Saint Michael during the reign of Pope Clement. Okay, a prototype of the reformatories for juvenile offenders. The next is the Walnut Street Jail. The Walnut Street Jail became the first American jail, and it was originally constructed as a detention jail and was converted into a state prisons. Okay, the Walnut Street Jail became known as the Pennsylvania system. Okay, Elmira Reformatory, it was opened in 1876 and was the first penal institution to remodel its penal philosophy away from punitive and retributive practices and veered it towards reformation and treatment. Another one is the Devil's Island, the most notorious prison in the world in terms of harshness of its regime and position. So the island is situated in the Atlantic off of the coast of French Guiana. Okay, and the other one is the Chateau, okay, the fortress that was built on the rocky islet of If, okay, 2 miles of France port and Marseilles. Okay, and in 1580 it was taken into use as a state prison for those convicted of serious political and religious crime. Okay, the Inspection House, it was founded by Jeremy Bentham, and Jeremy Bentham designed a prison model which was referred to as the Panopticon. Okay, Maison de Force, a house correction in Ghent, Belgium, which separate adult from juveniles as women from men, and an innovation to prison system during 1600s. Next is the Indiana Women's Prison. It was established in 1873 as the first adult female correctional facility in the country. And the prison holds Indiana's only death row for women. And Alcatraz, or known as the Rock. Okay, the prison is located on an island in San Francisco Bay. And it was built for the military in the 1850s and used by them as a fort and a prison until 1933. So when it passed to the Department of Justice and became a civil prison until it was closed in 1963. And the New York House of Refuge, the first established penal institution for youthful offenders. So those are the these are the prisons and the correctional institution, early prisons and correctional institution. Okay. So what is the difference between Auburn system and Pennsylvania system? So in Auburn, it was built in Auburn state of New York, kaya siya natawag na Auburn system. Okay. Tiny cells were built for individual prisoners where he is confined without an exercise. Okay, walang exercise yung mga preso dito. Okay, with the concept of solitary confinement and severe discipline. Okay, in Auburn system, any prisoner who dared to speak or make any sound at all was severely whipped. Papaluin naman yan. Okay, in Auburn system, was modified to allow the prisoner to work during daytime in common areas. Inmates are on contract convict list system with work lasting for 10 hours per day and 6 days per week. While in Pennsylvania, it is based on the concept of solitary confinement. Okay, its cells had a small exercise area, unlike dito sa Auburn, walang exercise area. to allow the prisoner to maintain physical condition, religious instruction, reflection upon crimes, reform through salvation, and religious enlightenment. So this is the difference between Auburn system and Pennsylvania system. Okay. So there are three institutions built in Pennsylvania. We have the Walnut Street Jail, Western Penitentiary, and the Eastern Penitentiary. Okay. So next is the five major deployment of prison existing in the US during the 20th century. First is we have the Northern Industrial Prison, Southern Plantation, the chain gangs, or costly oriented, and the treatment oriented prison. In the Northern Industrial Prison, there are three methods to benefit from the prison labor. We have through contract, state contract, and the state use system. So in the Northern Industrial Prison, it's found in the industrial belt of the Northern US. Okay. So in Northern Industrial Prison, prisoners are made to perform labor to earn revenues for the upkeep of the facility and the profit for the state treasury. Ginagamit nila yung mga preso para kumita yung estado. In the contract system, prisoners are hired out, nirerentahan yung mga preso, okay, sa mga businessmen or corporation on a daily basis for asset of fee. May bayad ang mayan per head. Okay, yan yung true contract. While the state account system, the contractors provided the raw materials and paid the state on a per piece price for each item produced or manufactured. That is the state account, kung saan ang mga contractors ang mag-provide ng mga raw materials. And the state use system is the state operate the business. Ang estado mismo ang mag-operate ng business. Lahat-lahat in all aspect, raw materials, lahat-lahat. Okay? Construct the factory, okay, by all raw materials, okay, and sila na ang nagpa-process, okay, sila na ang mag-process, sila din ang mag-handle ng kanyang marketing. That is the state use system. Next is the Southern Plantation, okay, because of the large area, agricultural area of this Southern Agricultural Prison, the penal institution possess the what we call the land vast land holdings and uses prison labor to produce agricultural products out of the land. Next is the chain gang. Okay, under this scheme, the prisoners work on public works project outside the facilities. Okay, but to secure the prisoners against escape, they are on the work site from far from prison, malayo sa facility, and they were chained together, okay, para hindi sila makatakas. Dito nagsimula yung tawag na chain gangs. Okay, next is custody oriented. So in custody oriented, this type of prison is a remnant of the prisons of the past century. When prisoners are punished by confining them only to their cells and isolating them from the rest of the society. Okay, and this custody-oriented prison is most commonly used in super maximum prisons. So in this type of prison, the riots is generally, or laging may riot dyan. And the other one is the treatment-oriented prison. The treatment-oriented prison is there are programs, okay, involved like educational, vocational, counseling, and other services. And the treatment programs were individualized in the treatment-oriented prison. Okay. So, bakit individualized program? Okay. To suit the particular treatment need of every inmate involving psychological, sociological, social, and many components. Okay. So these are the five major deployment of prison existing in the US in the 20th century. So the Huber Act, ano yung Huber Act? This is the law legalized work release program in the state of Wisconsin. Okay. So there are three landmarks of development in corrections in the US during in 19th century. So ano itong mga landmarks of development na ito that was occurred in the US in the 19th century? We have the parole, probation, and the abolition of death penalty. So dito sa parole, it was existed in it comes into existence in Elmira Reformatory in 1876. Okay, if a prisoner is maintains good conduct, okay, it was yung may re-record ang mayon for a period of 1 year. Okay, at the Elmira Reformatory. So then he can apply to be released on parole. Okay, dito sa parola, it also give rise to the indeterminate sentence law, where a prisoner is sentenced with a minimum and maximum period of imprisonment. Yun yung tinatawag nating indeterminate sentence, with a minimum and maximum period of imprisonment. So probation is mas naunang na-introduce itong probation kaysa parol. This was introduced in the US also by John Augustus, who regarded as the father of probation. And in the 1878, the first law authorizing a probation officer was passed in Massachusetts. And this is the third landmark development of the occurred in US correction, the abolition of death penalty. Tinanggal na yung death penalty. Okay? So that's all, and thank you, and God bless.